Hey guys, what is going on? This is Travis P11. I'd like to welcome you back to the channel. A week ago, I brought you just a quick little overview, and I guess you could say review, of this handguard made by Unique ARs. It's called the One Shot. We talked about the different sizes, the availability, the custom parts that Unique ARs happens to offer. And I said if the weather clears up, we're going to take this out and go ahead and shoot it. So here we are, a week later, and nothing has changed in eastern Nebraska. In fact, as we speak, it is a balmy 8 degrees below zero outside, and it feels like it's 25 below with a wind chill. So we're not going to go out to the range, probably at least for another week or so. And we're going to go and go back to this AR and talk about a few more of the components. And today, what I want to focus on is this lower receiver. This is made by Sharps Brothers, and it's called the Jack. And we'll go through the different features. We'll talk about what Sharps Brothers has to offer. We'll compare this to a standard just mil-spec lower receiver. Check out some of the differences, talk about it. And the big thing is magazine compatibility. So this AR-15 is on loan to me from Stan, the owner of SS Pawn in Lexington, Nebraska. And I want you guys to definitely make sure you check out SS Pawn. They've been a longtime supporter of the channel. And a lot of the content that you see here is from Stan's private collection. Now, Stan told me he was pretty sure that there was a little bit of difficulty with this accepting certain magazines, even though on the Sharps website they claim that there's complete, you know, magazine compatibility across the board and mil-spec part compatibility. So we're going to test that, just see if it'll actually just take magazines with no issues. All right, so let's go ahead and get started talking about the overall features of this lower receiver, the price, the specs, and then we'll get into a little more detail. All right, so real quick, I don't want to bore you with the details, but I think you want to know what you're getting yourself into when you spend this kind of money on a lower receiver. So first of all, you can buy it over places like Rainier and also Brownells for around $295.99. And so this is the Gen 2, which has features that now include a threaded bolt catch pin, reduced weight, and improved styling. It has an oversized integrated trigger guard, a beveled magazine flare that helps you load as quickly and efficiently as possible, a machine top to bottom from 7075 T6 aluminum. It has a hard coat anodized mil-spec finish, full compatibility with all mil-spec internal parts, full compatibility with all other aftermarket mil-spec upper receivers, and full compatibility with P-Mags, Hex-Mags, and other standard capacity magazines. So we'll run just a variety of different magazines, just loading, unloading, see how well it actually takes them, and see if there's any issues. It also has a multi-caliber markings on it with a weight of 10.7 ounces. Now, Sharps Brothers does carry lower receivers and upper receivers and a ton of custom parts for AR-15, for AR-10, Kalashnikov rifles, bolt-action rifles, Thompson Center has its own section, and so on. So make sure you check out Sharps Brothers because they've got a lot of really cool parts. All right, so here we go. Let's go ahead and check magazine compatibility. We're going to start off with an ASD, just ASC standard GI steel mag, and see what happens there. Okay, no problems. Obviously, we can't test the cycling or anything like that, but it does take it, no problems whatsoever. And, yep, comes right out. All right, how about a Ross Defense Systems Unimag? These are a little bit finicky because they're adjusted and set up for multiple calibers. So we'll see what happens here. Okay, no problems. That's actually pretty tight on my PSA lower receiver, so that's a good sign. Here's an old roller mag that's made by ProMag. Okay, it does take it. Okay, I can see the round up in there. Okay, it's good to go. No problems. Ejection, ooh, it is stuck. Okay, we're gonna work on this one off camera. All right, so that took a considerable amount of force. You might wanna pass on the ProMag roller mags if you can even find them anymore. I've had those sitting around for a while. Standard Gen M2, I believe, PMag 30. There we go, no problems at all. A little bit of space up in there. Okay, ejection comes right out. And finally, the Hex Mag. Yeah, Hex Mag is what we have here. Okay, good. It's got a little bit of space there, that's a good sign. And doesn't pop out quite as easily as a P-Mag, but just a little bit of pressure comes right out. All right, so it's a little noisy out there in the kitchen, so we're gonna go ahead and bring it to this back room so you can check out the details. So just as a comparison, here's just your standard lower receiver. There's some fingerprints on there, I do apologize. You know, EPT trigger from Palmetto State Armory, PSA lower build, okay. Just really, really just box stock, except for the MOE furniture on there, from what you're used to in just a standard AR-15. I'll check out the Sharps. Lots of attention to detail going on there. Completely milled, or however they make this thing, CNC machined out of a single piece of aluminum. Slightly enhanced for your positions on your fire and safe and full auto. Of course, you know, obviously it's not set up for that, but Hogue grip going on there. And it was mated up with an Aero Precision upper. No issues whatsoever. The trigger, it might be an aftermarket trigger. I'm not 100% sure. It's a little bit lighter than just a standard mil spec, so it might be a Geissele or something. I'm not sure exactly. We'll have to see. I'll have to ask Stan what the trigger is. You can see the top here. Really no surprises. Okay, let's go ahead and flip it over. Again, the pins, no trouble with the takedown pins in the front or the back. You know, sometimes Anderson ones can be a little bit finicky, but the Sharps ones are just fine. Again, just as a comparison, standard Anderson lower. And again, these are registered lowers, so you're going to have to go through your FFL, and you know they're going to be, they're not like an 80% job or anything like that, so you're going to have to get them however you normally get your lowers and go through the whole process. But really, just a really cool design. I do like kind of like the Legionnaire style one that they have for Sharps also. Lots of detail. Okay, let's flip this over here. Check out the teeth. That's pretty cool. Definitely see it is flared out a little bit. There's a bit of a, oops, there you go. Bit of an angle, which I'm not sure if you can see it very well, but it is flared out just a little bit for ease of insertion and extraction of your magazines. But as we discovered with that roller mag, it was a little bit tight. But most of your just standard commercial mags, I don't think you're going to have any issues. Your GI mags are going to be good to go. Not sure what the stock is. I'm not sure if this is also a Sharps Brothers part, but it's just what came on the AR and Stan loaned it to me. So just as a comparison, you can kind of see how it goes head to head. So is it worth, you know, up to three, maybe four times more than just a standard low receiver? I don't know. If you want to do a, you know, kind of a project to have a skull theme going on, or if you like that style, or if you're a fan of the Punisher and whatnot, you know, a lot of people don't really care and they want to customize their ARs and make them look cool. So that's totally up to you. I like it. I think it's really sweet. And, you know, looking at it, you're thinking, oh my gosh, a $300 lower. But when you see it in person, it's just really, really cool. Just kind of fun. You know, it's kind of fun to customize it. I mean, really, why do people drop thousands and thousands of dollars in their cars? It's just because they enjoy them and they want to kind of make them unique and make them their own. So I really don't blame them for that. All right, so final thoughts on this particular build so far. I just absolutely love it. It is so cool. It's got so much style. It's very unique. And, you know, everything just kind of goes together. I think it's really awesome. Obviously, I haven't fired it yet. Don't know how the reliability is going to be or the function. But things look pretty promising right now. So hopefully, if we are above freezing, we'll have an opportunity to take it out and put a few rounds down range and just test it, get the scope dialed in and just see what it can do. I'm really excited to test out the optic that's on here. It's a Leopold VXR Patrol 1.25 to 4 power by 20 millimeter objective lens. And so it should be really cool to take out. So that's my take on some of the initial components, but it's looking pretty fun. So that's it, guys. Make sure you like and subscribe. Check out my channel. We're going to be bringing you some more range tests here very soon, as soon as it warms up a little bit. I want you guys to have fun. I want you to be safe. Have yourselves a great weekend. Stay warm. And as you know, we will talk to you soon. All right. Bye-bye.